Hello everyone, welcome to the second part of the video of using Kubernetes with Telepresence. If you haven't checked out the first video, make sure to do that first. Coming back to Telepresence, Telepresence facilitates local code execution while connected to a Kubernetes cluster, eliminating the need for constant redeployment and streamlining the development process. Alright, check out this simple Go app. It's got a couple of REST APIs and two HTTP handlers all set up. The home handler will simply return a static JSON response. The data handler simulates an error that could occur in a production environment. To do this, a random number is generated each time the API is called. If that number exceeds 5, an exception is raised. This scenario can only be tested when the environment variable is set to production. This is just one example of how Telepresence can help you identify the root cause of an issue. We are attempting to replicate this issue in our local environment. Let's now return to our main function. You may have noticed the wrapper function called portlogger. It's essentially a decorator function that not only prints the hostname and port number, but also centrally manages exceptions raised by the handlers. In case you haven't noticed before, the handlers returns errors that are managed by the portlogger decorator. Now, let's go ahead and run the application. The message in the home handler will render if you go to localhost 8080. Alright, so hitting that load dataset endpoint works fine when we are running locally, obviously. But we need to see what happens when the code is actually running in production. Let's deploy this to a Kubernetes cluster and see what breaks. Okay, you can see the logs. This is what I was referring to before. It's going to print the host and port. Let's now move on to the Docker file and build the image. Okay, first up, make sure Docker desktop with Kubernetes is up and running. But hey, no pressure. You can totally use Kind or Minikube, whatever works for you. All right, let's tweak that Docker file. Go ahead and hit Edit Docker file and double check that image tag says go_telepresence. Then apply those changes and build the image. The image build is done. Let's deploy it to our local Kubernetes cluster. So I have got this YAML file ready. It will spin up a deployment with one instance. It's going to use the Go Telepresence image we built. Now, you might be thinking, wait, we didn't push that to Docker Hub. No worries. It will grab it from the local machine's cache. Just make sure the image policy is set to never. That way, it won't try to pull it from Docker Hub and will just use what's on your system. Okay, so I threw in a production environment variable. Just a heads up, it's because we have got some code in the data handler that kicks in when things are set for production. Basically, we are just mimicking that production setup. The next step is to create a Kubernetes service, and the target port will be set to 8080. All right, so to deploy, pop open the services tool window, then connect to your cluster. You will see Docker desktop if that's not what you're using, or Minikube if that's your thing. Once connected, just head over to the right and you'll find apply to cluster Docker desktop. That will push the changes to the default namespace. Okay, so you can see the Go app is running smoothly and the service is up in networks. Now, just a heads up before we jump into Telepresence, let's tweak things a bit. Head over to your run configuration and add an environment variable called env and sets its value to production. This will help us replicate the issue we want to look at. Go ahead and run the server. Alright, let's talk Telepresence now. What exactly Telepresence is going to do and how it's going to help us. For example, if your application is running inside Kubernetes on a pod, and you are developing locally, say on port 8080, Telepresence can route requests intended for the Kubernetes service to your local service. This way, you can work on your local machine while still testing and interacting with the rest of the application running inside Kubernetes. Alright, head over to the Services tool window, find Docker desktop, and on the right, you will spot an icon that's like arrows going outwards, shaped like a Y. Click that to hook up with Telepresence. You will need your root password for this. In the background, it will create a traffic manager pod in the ambassador namespace. If you are doing it for the first time, then it will prompt you to install the traffic manager. A traffic manager in Telepresence routes and manages network traffic between the local and remote environments to ensure seamless communication. The traffic manager pod will be created in the background within the ambassador namespace. This namespace is utilized due to its association with Ambassador Labs, the organization responsible for developing Telepresence. Okay, traffic manager is up and running. Let's set up our first intercept. Hit create new interception. Basically, we can pick either a deployment or replica set for the service. I'm going to use deployment here and set the interception port to 8080. So, Telepresence is up and running and grabbing that traffic. Now, you can just pop open your browser and hit the Go App service. If you remember, we already defined this service in the YAML file. Okay, so as you can see, now we are intercepting the traffic that's going to the pod, and you can also confirm this with the application logs. Now, if I try to hit the endpoint load dataset, it should run, but as you can see, it failed, which we are going to debug. Basically, if you are seeing exceptions, you'll likely have the same issues in production. Sure, alerts and metrics are useful, but Telepresence helps smooth things out before you deploy, reducing those problems in the first place. We have got this code that's set up to return either a success or an error message, depending on a random number. If the number is over 5, it throws an error. So yeah, it's pretty much a coin flip. Sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. Okay, let's jump back to the code. I'll fire up the debugger and drop a breakpoint right here. Please enter the password. Alright, let's hit the API again. The debugger should sort us out. Yeah, it failed. Turns out, the random number was 9, which is greater than 5. Anyway, I hope that shows you just how simple it is to debug a pod using Telepresence. Sometimes, digging into containers for debugging can be a real pain. I much prefer this method. No need to jump inside the container or wait around for alerts to appear. Alright. So now you get how Telepresence lets you run your code locally while it's still connected to a Kubernetes cluster, right? That's a big help for making development and debugging faster. If you like the video, hit those like, share and subscribe buttons. Thanks a bunch and have a great day.